to South Sudan, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, I don't know how this is possible, my people, but the vice president is missing. I'm like, what happened? The vice president be missing. The man has been missing now for days. Only for me to hear that the man has been replaced by another person. I was like, whoa, this is too much. Too much for me to take at a time. You mean to tell me the vice president is missing? You don't know where he is? But instead of looking for him, the president decided to replace him within 48 hours. Within 48 hours, what is going on in South Sudan? For those that may not understand, that is like saying that our vice president, Yemi Osinbajo, is missing. And then, instead of us to look for the man, the president decided to replace him. You'll be like, what? I mean, I don't know details of the politics in South Sudan, but if our vice president is missing, I thought we would be looking for him, not replacing him. By the way, last week after I talked about South Sudan, I got a lot of messages from a lot of South Sudanese. So many of them asking, who are you? Like, really? How dare you talk about South Sudan? They said, why not face Boko Haram that you have in Nigeria? How dare you talk about South Sudan? So let me introduce myself in case any new South Sudanese is watching my show. Hi, my name is Adeola. I do talk about African politics on my show, and I make sure to always talk about Nigeria first. Like you said, I talk about Boko Haram, I talk about everything that is happening in Nigeria, but I can also talk about other African countries. That is why I'm talking about your country. So now that we have met each other, let me continue. As I was saying, things are heating up in South Sudan following the recent violence that erupted in the capital Juba, you know, a few weeks ago. The vice president fled the capital Juba, and many people still don't know where the man is right now. The only thing that we know is the man is speaking from wherever he is. They have two vice presidents in South Sudan. So this man that is missing is the first vice president. He said that he fled because he's afraid for his life. He said this new appointment by the president is illegal. According to the peace deal that was signed in 2015, a new vice president can only be appointed by the armed opposition under the leadership of Makar, that is the vice president that is missing right now. Now, many people are concerned that this move by the president could potentially undermine the peace deal that was reached between the president and his vice. People are worried about the possible repercussions of the replacement. Even the UN is saying that the president of South Sudan should respect this peace deal that was signed. And then when the UN condemned this appointment, guess what the president did? He got some members of the opposition to say that they are part of the new appointment, just so he can say, well, I mean, I don't think that he genuinely cares about the man. If you don't see your vice president for 48 hours and you just replace him like that, something is not right. I would be suspicious. Anyway, all I know is the vice president that is missing said that he's not coming back until his safety can be guaranteed in South Sudan, and he wants the president to go by the peace deal that was signed in 2015. You guys know I don't know much. Guess what? I'm just keeping it real.